You're watching W33BY, Detroit, Highland Park, Michigan. The views and opinions expressed on the following show are not necessarily the views and opinions of W33BY, its affiliates, management, or sponsors.
Good morning, good morning, good morning, AM Detroit. This is your host, Burgess Foster, host of 96 West, a cutting-edge public affairs talk show where we cover the scope of human experience. We like to say that we're the type of show where we exchange ideas on the information highway. So today, you don't see any guests to my left or to my right now. We have invited a few folks onto the show live. We are going to be possibly talking to the Sierra Club, a nationally known environmental group that tries to preserve and conserve Mother Earth. So they'll be calling in all the way from Grand Rapids or wherever they are out there doing business, lobbying on behalf of the environment. Earth has an advocate in the Sierra Club. And again, I'm your host, Burgess Foster, host of 96 West, the show where everyone's affairs in the public are of concern. So just in general, I wanted to maybe open up the call-in line immediately to anyone out there. If you saw the recent Stephanie Chang, state representative in the 6th District, she wrote an open-ed piece in the Detroit News. And Stephanie Chang basically talked about air pollution. She mentioned the fact that AK Steel has been violating a lot of the environmental standards. AK Steel is a company in Dearborn, Michigan, that has somewhat rebuffed for having to go by high emission standards in terms of industrial pollution. They don't think that it is possible to have zero infractions. And so out of 168 companies, 152 of them, according to the op-ed piece by Stephanie Chang, a representative in the 6th District, and Duraney, who is also a state representative out of Dearborn, They kind of co-wrote this piece together, and they found that out of 168 companies, 152 complied. That is amazing. 152 companies complied with zero infractions. And so obviously the other 16 companies, they missed an infraction or two, and so they can't fully get the tax credit that they're looking for. And so in the Michigan House, bill number 5557, that's House Bill 5557, was reported out of committee. One of the individuals that helped to get the ball out of committee and onto the House floor set for a vote was the gentleman, State Representative Wendell Byrd, in District 3 that yours truly is running against. Now, Wendell Byrd voted to allow AK Steel to be able to receive their tax credit without 100% compliance. And so Stephanie Chang, the state representative in District 6, and Representative Duraney out of Dearborn basically voted against this. They're advocating against it. And I just wanted to bring it to your attention. This is a bill, 5557, that the Sierra Club says is bad business for the environment, for Wayne County, for the state of Michigan, for our waters, for our air. As you well know, when pollutants and particulates go into the air, they get into the clouds, which get into the rain, which get into the soil. And so there you have it, folks. And there's something called inversion. Now, I'm no climate scientist, but this inversion sort of works like this, ladies and gentlemen. When there's some warm air, it actually traps the cold air and it blocks the air from circulating so that pollutants can be filtered out naturally as much as possible. And so Stephanie Chang and others are fighting to have what they call a special day of recognition for this inversion. If the weatherman comes on and says that there's a certain level of inversion in the atmosphere, a warning will go out to let individuals know who might be susceptible to this type of condition, like asthmatics and other individuals. This is just smart legislation. Now, everything that Stephanie Chang has done, Representative Stephanie Chang has done in Lansing, this talk show host does not agree with, but I'm in support of her stance against 557, House Bill 5557, because it allows polluters like AK Steel to get a tax credit when they are not in 100% compliance. You know, as you start to vet and evaluate different individuals running for public office, and please call in. The number is not up here on the screen, but I know it by heart. 313-868-4336. That's 313-868-4336. And the numbers are on the screen. Call into the show. Let's talk about the environment. Let's talk about water issues. Let's talk about air pollution. Let's talk about homeschooling. Let's talk about the school board issue again, if that's what you want to do. We could talk about what's happening with the golf course at 7 Mile and Woodward. It looks horrible. We need to, and I was at an event where the Honorable Brenda Jones was there, keynote speaking and addressing some of these issues. She did a good job of informing the general public about what's going on city council. There's been recently a $5 million expenditure. $4 million of it was paid by the city of Detroit. $1 million of it was paid by the federal government to equip our police officers with body cameras. These body cameras, according to the Honorable Councilwoman Brenda Jones, should help us cut down on lawsuits. How, you might ask? Well, I think it's pretty evident that in a case when it's an officer's word against a citizen's word, then we have the empirical evidence, as my professors used to always say, the things that we can see and touch. We can look at the video, and the video, if it's undoctored and unaltered, we have to say that, all right? Then we can trust that information to divulge to us, expose to us, reveal to us what is actually happening. So I think that the body cameras are a good idea. Don't know if the $5 million price tag was the cheapest bid that was out there, but it is a move in the right direction to to equip our police officers with this type of technology. So please call into the show, 313-868-4336. I'm your host, Burgess Foster of 96 West, a cutting edge public affairs talk show that covers the gamut and scope and breadth of the human experience, talking about health issues, talking about legal issues, talking about business issues. We have invited guests from around the country that are we're looking forward to coming on the show soon, and I'm looking forward to for you to call in. We have a call on line one.
Good morning, my brother.
Yes, good morning. And who are we speaking with today?
You're talking to Kurt.
Hi, Kurt. What's on your mind today, Kurt?
Well, you was on point about one issue, and that's the body cameras. I think what that'll do, by them having to wear them, that's going to change their attitude about how they act in the street. In other words, things that they would have done before, they're not going to do anymore.
Yes, Kurt.
It's not about them getting away with it. The fact is that they're not going to do it in the first place. Beat somebody down on the street or shoot somebody in the back or choke somebody to death. By that camera being on them, that alone is going to change things. So, I'm all in for the camera. But as far as this environment, man, this is just my personal opinion.
Go ahead, Kurt.
I think it's a wrap anyway. Why I think this, because if you ever viewed this video called Space from Earth, Earth from Space, it came on National Geographic, and what it was talking about is how the winds revolve around the Earth.
Okay.
The power of the gravitational pull of the sun.
Yes.
You know, and I'm coupling this with my history that I read.
Okay.
You know, and basically what it is that this land was pure and clean during the time before they took it from the American Indian.
Okay.
In other words, the pollution that they have produced since this time, you know, this short period of time. So there's 150,000 years of civilization in front of that. But these people knew that they had to work in the balance of nature. They didn't do anything to interrupt or modify anything in nature, like building dams.
Okay,
or
Kurt.
Burning coal, which it produces.
Okay, Kurt, I heard your two issues. I'm going to pose a question to you on both. Stay with me right here on the line, and you and I are going to have a dialogue, and then we'll try to turn to and get some other callers to call in.
Okay.
So my first question back to you, Kurt, is, you know, you kind of sparked an idea with me. Why couldn't we, from time to time, have it so that those body cams can be broadcast onto public access, like, for example, you have 100 cops out or maybe 200 police officers out or maybe more on a shift. They'll go from squad car to squad car, just revealing to you, say on, I don't know if Comcast 9-1 would be the station, but on some station on cable where you could actually see, the public can actually view what's going on from time to time in different cars. That also would make officers stay on their A game, so to speak. What would you think about an idea like that, Kurt?
Man, I think that idea is on point. See, you spark me. I mean, I spark you and you spark me. When you can look at what the police are doing on the street, this is what they're already doing to you. You know these gas stations, they're talking about putting these green lights in. Do you know that's a direct feed to the police station?
Can you talk a little bit clearer into the phone, Kurt?
Yes. They can see everybody that comes into one of those gas stations. They call it the green light gas station. You're going to see a green revolving light over top of those gas stations. This is being viewed by the police department. And they always say, well, you ain't doing nothing wrong. What's wrong with it? Well, we're run that right back on you. If you ain't
very good,
wrong,
Kurt.
What's wrong with us looking at you on TV?
Okay, my next question, Kurt. Outstanding response. You're right. What's good for the goose is good for the gander, right, Kurt? So let me ask you this. Well, let me state this. Of course, now we're talking about industrialization. So, you know, the Industrial Revolution took place in Europe first, according to the history books, and then over here in the United States. with the steamboat, with the railroad, and so forth, the movement of goods and people. Of course, now the Native Americans didn't have much industrialization. This is one of the what they call the latent effects, something that is not necessarily thought to happen immediately, but could happen as a result. So, for example, a latent effect of the automobile is drinking and driving. No one really thought about drinking and driving when Ford was putting out his 10 Lizzies, all in the color of black. You know, Ford said, if you want any color, you can get any color you want as long as it's black. And so when they were producing Model Ts, they didn't think about drinking and driving or needing seat belts and things of that nature. So one other question, Kurt, before you leave as an aside. Now, they say you're an adult at age 18 because you can enter into legal contracts, Kurt, and you can also join the military. However, I find it somewhat paradoxical that someone can lay down their life for their country, but they can't buy a beer or a drink, which is legal. What do you think the legal age is, Kurt? Is it 18 or is it 21, man? Talk to me.
It was 21 when I was a kid, and you know what?
Right.
A lot of children didn't even attempt to get engaged. I mean, of course you had some, but you didn't have no high percentage of people, 19, 20, 21, doing no heavy drinking. Why? Because I lived on the street called Holbrook, which is not too far from
North
the
end.
Plan on I-75 in Holbrook. And as I was sitting on my porch playing in the neighborhood, I would always see the traffic come from that place. So that encouraged me to want to be there because the people who I saw that worked there had gator shoes on, lizard shoes. They were sharp every weekend, had pretty girls and nice cars. And man, that's what I want, you know. So, and then my dad worked at the plant. So doing something, working, I wouldn't say that they deliberately was pressing it on you, but it was visible. You saw it, and it was something that you wanted to do. But drinking, as far as the drinking, man, no, right now, I've drunk too much, man. I'm sick because I've drunk too much.
So the age should be 21. You think the legal age of adulthood should be 21 because it gives the teen, the 18 and the 19-year-old, who, by the definition, are still teens, maybe another 2 years to mature. Is that correct?
That's correct. But you see, when you get to, when you use an age like 21, that's just something they're going to use against you.
Well, we got to have a standard, Kurt. I want to thank you for calling in. I'm going to take another call, Kurt. Thank you for the dialogue, Kurt. I appreciate it very much.
All right.
Next. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you get an opportunity to call into the show, we don't have anyone out there right now. We want to talk about various issues. It doesn't make a difference what it is. It could be the very fact that we're talking about the legal age. Is it 18? Is it 19? 20? Or 21? I could join the military at 18. I can vote at 18. I can enter into legal contracts at 18. But ladies and gentlemen, do not touch that channel. Put the clicker down. Put it down. Put it down. Stay with me. And when we come back, we're going to have some more interesting issues to talk about in just a second on 96 West. I was telling y'all about.
Vote Burgess Foster, State Rep, District 3, August 2nd, 2016. As a state rep, Burgess will hold crooked principals accountable in the Detroit Public School District. He will fight for prevailing wages. Burgess Foster will use his creative ideas to draw businesses that are not currently located in Detroit. Burgess Foster will be an employee of the people. He has taught as a school teacher, a college professor, born and raised in Detroit, and a graduate of Southeastern High School. Vote Burgess Foster, State Rep, District 3. Paid for by the friends to elect Burgess Foster.
Have you ever wanted your own TV show? Have you dreamed of showcasing your talent for the world to see? Well, now you can. Have your own TV show. For only $99, you can have your own 30-minute show. Not only will you be seen in the Detroit area, but you can be viewed worldwide. Be seen on WHPR Detroit Live, Comcast Cable Channel 91, on the web at TV33WHPR.com, with the TV33 app, on Roku, Google TV, Apple TV, and on Amazon Fire TV. Act now. Time slots are limited. Sign up today and get a free replay with the purchase of your time slot. For more information, call 313-868-6612. Visit our studios and receive a free TV interview to promote your business, church, or organization by appointment only.
Vote Burgess Foster for State Rep. District 3, August 2nd, 2016. As a state rep, Burgess will hold crooked principals accountable in the Detroit Public School District. He will fight for prevailing wages. Burgess Foster will use his creative ideas to draw businesses that are not currently located in Detroit. Burgess Foster will be an employee of the people. He has taught as a school teacher, a college professor, born and raised in Detroit, and a graduate of Southeastern High School. Vote Burgess Foster, State Rep, District 3. Paid for by the friends to elect Burgess Foster.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning again. This is your host, Burgess Foster of 96 West, a cutting-edge public affairs talk show covering the scope of human experience. We like to say that we are the place where ideas are exchanged on the information superhighway, the freeway of thinking. Ladies and gentlemen, please call into the show, 313-868-4336. I implore you so that we can talk and discuss about many multifarious subjects that you might want to talk about. We just finished having a nice cap with Kurt. We talked about the voting age. Should the voting age be 18, 19, or 20, or 21? Should the legal age of adulthood be 18, 19, 20, or 21? I mean, that's some serious consideration. We had to have an amendment to the United States Constitution to allow those under 21 the right to vote. This happened in the 1970s. What was happening was folks were going off to Vietnam. They were dying for their country at 18, 19, and 20, and 21. But many folks who are under 21 couldn't vote, but they were dying for their country. And so the congressman and the senators and the president got together and said, you know, that's not right. So it allowed individuals, mainly who are in their teens, 18 and 19 year olds and 20 year olds as well, the right to vote. And now I mention that again only because I'm seriously thinking that maybe this is what's wrong with our young people. Maybe a little bit they need to mature 2 extra years. You know, 18, 19, and 20, maybe that shouldn't be the legal age of accountability. Maybe it should be the age of 21. That would have a lot of ramifications in the legal justice system. Because now, theoretically, I couldn't say that you're an adult until you're 21. And that if you're less than 21, I would still have to consider you a M-I-N-O-R, minor. And so it gives our people, our young people, an opportunity to mature before they want to go out here and buy liquor or gamble in a casino or enter into legal contracts. Give them an opportunity to at least graduate from Wayne County Community College or Oakland Community College or Macomb Community College. Now, there are other issues for us to talk about. There are homeschool issues. As a matter of fact, the Detroit Department of Transportation is now putting, I think, 2 bus lines on 24-hour service. Remember, 24-hour service was cut in the city of Detroit for nearly 10 years. I think the 24-hour lines are, and I could be mistaken, but I think I'll get most of these right, Route 53, which is Woodward, because I used to catch the bus before I had a vehicle. I'm one of the few folks that's running for state representative in any district who could tell you some of the bus lines and what they are. Like, for example, I think a bus route 17 is the 8 mile. Bus route 16 is Dexter. 53 is Woodward. And also you have the Gratiot line that is 24 hours and possibly Grand River, You know, the number 10, I believe it's the Shane route and things of that nature. You know, you really need public officials who are elected who know what these bus routes are. You know, some folks say that, why do I need to know what the bus route is? I'm on city council, or I'm a state rep, or, you know, I'm a county commissioner. Well, in many instances, if mass transit comes before you and you don't know, for example, what these bus routes are, but you're making decisions on 24-hour service or budgets to the transportation sector, I think it's smart for you to understand what the routes are. And let me tell you, it's interesting that when you ride the bus route as a public official, you actually find out what the citizens are going through when they're waiting in the rain and the bus is late. It's not the bus driver's fault most of the time. They only drive the buses that are assigned to them. And so I'm a great friend of Local Transit 26 and ATU 26 for SMART and DDOT. I support the drivers. They have a tough job dealing with the public who are sometimes not very cooperative, let's just say. We need to be cooperative so that we all can have a pleasant and productive day. Ladies and gentlemen, there's so many different types of issues for us to have a discussion about. Call into the show. We're going to be taking a break in about 30 seconds here, sooner or later. And 313-868-0351 was the call-in number. We wanted you to call into the show. Guess we'll be wrapping up. And so, listen, as we tune in for next Friday, we've invited some major sponsors out there, Bank of America, Dow Chemical, Myers, General Motors, Lyft, Uber, a lot of different companies that we're reaching out to sponsor our show so that we might be able to do some more creative things and bring on students who are doing well in the school district. I have an idea for that. I want to also bring on an attorney and do something called At Bar, where citizens can call in and get free legal advice from attorneys. You stay tuned to 96 West, and you will be pleasantly pleased at some of our programming ideas. I really enjoyed being with you this morning. It's always an honor and a pleasure to serve you in this capacity and offer an open channel and freeway of thinking. Thank you so very kindly. See you next Friday.
Vote Burgess Foster for State Rep, District 3, August 2nd, 2016. As a state rep, Burgess will hold crooked principals accountable in the Detroit Public School District. He will fight for prevailing wages. Burgess Foster will use his creative ideas to draw businesses that are not currently located in Detroit. Burgess Foster will be an employee of the people. He has taught as a school teacher, a college professor, born and raised in Detroit, and a graduate of Southeastern High School. Vote Burgess Foster, State Rep, District 3, paid for by the Friends to Elect Burgess Foster.
Have you ever wanted your own TV show? Have you dreamed of showcasing your talent for the world to see? Well, now you can. Have your own TV show. For only $99, you can have your own 30-minute show. Not only will you be seen in the Detroit area, but you can be viewed worldwide. Be seen on WHPR Detroit Live, Comcast Cable Channel 91, on the web at TV33WHPR.com. With the TV33 app, on Roku, Google TV, Apple TV, and on Amazon Fire TV. Act now, time slots are limited. Sign up today and get a free replay with the purchase of your time slot. For more information, call 313-868-6612. Visit our studios and receive a free TV interview to promote your business, church, or organization by appointment only.
Vote Burgess Foster for State Rep, District 3, August 2nd, 2016. As a state rep, Burgess will hold crooked principals accountable in the Detroit Public School District. He will fight for prevailing wages. Burgess Foster will use his creative ideas to draw businesses that are not currently located in Detroit. Burgess Foster will be an employee of the people. He has taught as a school teacher, a college professor, born and raised in Detroit, and a graduate of Southeastern High School. Vote Burgess Foster, state rep, District 3. Paid for by the friends to elect Burgess Foster.